In Carnegie Mellon University's Environmental Engineering Lab, students and faculty work together to tackle the complex challenge of creating a cleaner, more energy-efficient world. With cutting-edge research that sits at the intersection of water quality and climate change, researchers are focused on critical issues that impact the future of our planet. Our researchers are improving technologies for water treatment.
In improving our technologies for water treatment and in improving decisions we make upstream of that treatment. So should we allow a certain contaminant to enter the water? Should we allow a new user to come in and use a large amount of water? How should we manage the water that agriculture is taking and energy is taking versus what we're taking at our households?
We are developing new remediation technology.
We work on a variety of things in my research group. Currently, we focus on what is called environmental nanotechnology. One component is to leverage the unique properties of nanomaterials to develop new technologies for remediation of, say, groundwater or water treatment. And then the other aspect of what we're doing has to do with understanding the implications of nanomaterials in the environment. Right now, there's many nano-enabled products that are entering the marketplace, and people and the government want to know whether these nanomaterials, which are novel materials, whether they're going to cause any problems in the environment. And to really understand properly the impacts and the fate of the material, you have to study them within a complex system.
Improving water quality and water resources.
In some areas, there won't be enough water available, fresh water, for new power production. We are investigating water sources such as treated municipal wastewater, drainage from abandoned mines, or saltier groundwaters that haven't been looked to as a primary source of cooling water for power production. Another area that we've investigated is the use of water, impacts of water, in geological storage of carbon dioxide. This is a technology under development to keep CO2 out of the atmosphere, to inject it deep in the ground. When we do that, the CO2 will mix with native groundwaters, it will move around and interact with rocks and potentially impact groundwater resources.
The Department of Civil and Environmental Engineering has recently begun to transform and modernize the Environmental Engineering Lab, a space that hasn't been updated in 25 years. This renovation is an investment in future water quality pioneers and water management leaders.
My research is lab intensive and also data analytic intensive. So that means I have to switch around to different instruments, go back to my lab bench space, and then go to my desk pretty much every day. And I think with this new lab, it has a new workflow. It's really open up and really connected. This new renovated lab, I think it would really help us to collaborate and work together. This new opportunity with this lab space is gonna really help us out. So I wanna take that money and really show that you invested in our future and also CMU's future.